Envision a future of personalized medicine where genomics plays a big part of how patients are evaluated for risk of disease. One way is with polygenic risk scores, calculations that can assess our genetic risk for a certain complex condition or disease. But what are they, and how are they calculated? First, we need to understand polygenicity. With a monogenic condition, like cystic fibrosis, we know that the presence of a single allele inherited from each parent will lead to inheritance of the disease. But with complex diseases, like Parkinson's disease, or say, coronary artery disease, it's much more complicated. Many genes are implicated with disease, resulting from hundreds or thousands of variants, each having a small effect that, when added together, could determine someone's genetic predisposition for a disease. That genetic risk doesn't mean they'll necessarily have coronary artery disease. There are still other factors to consider, like lifestyle and environment. But what we can do is assess their genetic risk based on their genotype, then possibly inform lifestyle changes to mitigate their overall risk of disease. So how do we calculate polygenic risk scores? Well, they require large genotype studies to collect enough data to develop an algorithm. First, researchers recruit thousands of subjects to make up a control group and a disease phenotype group, or access data from a large biobank. Genome-wide association studies identify all of the variants associated with the disease phenotype by including variants, or SNPs, that are significantly associated with the trait of interest. Then, they assign weight to each variant. Some are weighted more heavily than others, depending on effect size. Also accounting for heritability, this information is used to develop an algorithm that will compute a polygenic risk score. A validation study is then conducted to determine how accurate it is in distinguishing between the control and disease cohorts. Validated risk scores can then be applied to the population while keeping this in mind. A polygenic risk score is only giving the relative risk compared with the specific population it was created with. That's why it's falling somewhere on a distribution curve. And it's important to develop a risk score algorithm with the ethnic population it is intended for. Applying an algorithm designed on data of European descent to a person in Japan might not be as accurate. So different scoring algorithms will be needed for different populations. In some countries, polygenic risk scores are already being piloted in healthcare systems. In the near future, polygenic risk scores could be another personalized factor in assessing risk for complex diseases. And from one genotyping test, polygenic risk scores could be calculated across many different diseases for an individual. How will polygenic risk scores benefit your disease area of interest?